Hey everyone, welcome back to Link's Crossbow Training. This will be the final video of me playing through this minigame. Just going to go through the last two levels and have fun with it. Oh, this is the stage with the Darknut battle. Thought it was the next one. There is another boss battle for the next stage, however. Or level, rather. I keep using stage and level, like, however I want, you know? Damn it! I changed position and it's apparently extremely horrible for me. Then again, I'm also on horseback, so maybe that's not helping things. Just enjoy yourself, White Hawk. Have fun playing this. And what the hell? Seriously, Epona? You sent me through the loading screen before I actually got, hit that target. Ugh. I'll do better this time. You know what? This stage makes me want a Majora's Mask crossbow training to happen. Y'all realize that? But it kind of already exists in the form of the Romani Ranch. There's this exercise where to unlock the pony, you have to hit 10 targets in like 2 minutes. Anyway, yeah, I did pretty horribly. Definitely not going to be getting the gold, that's for sure. Okay, so I guess to get bronze, you have to get 20,000. Silver, 40,000. Gold, 60,000. And platinum, 80,000. Yeah. Also got to protect myself. Damn it. Got him. Damn it. They stop moving every once in a while, and here comes a horde. Or a herd, rather. Damn it. How the hell are you supposed to protect yourself? By being super good, I guess. I mean, they were all coming down, and I had plenty of opportunity to take out most of them, but keeping your multiplier at the same time is probably extremely challenging. I guess if you want to keep your multiplier while using the bombs, you need to actually hit something in the, like, in its face with the bomb. Yeah. Okay, I get it now. Maybe. I might be wrong after all. And oh yeah, the Darknut battle. This is one of the highlights of Link's crossbow training. Because it's got, I mean, it's got a cutscene now, you know? It's pretty much the same one as in Twilight Princess. However, the fight itself is completely different. Really, it is. Because this Darknut is Dracula. Or something. Gotta hit this thing. I mean, I actually want to beat this boss. Yep, keep shielding my blows. And I'll hit your back. That's pretty much what you have to do, let's be honest. Oh, come on, those shots did not count. Too bad for me, I suppose. Yeah, you don't bother trying to hit the shield. It's not gonna work. Come on. No more shield, but it's not over yet. Come on. Yeah, he's actually kind of difficult to beat in this form. Are you gonna try to attack me? Damn it. How am I gonna beat you if you keep doing that? Yeah, he teleports around like this. Cool, huh? And I'm not gonna beat in time, unfortunately. I was close, however. I was close. You know what? Just cause this is gonna be a slightly shorter video compared to the previous one, I'm actually gonna do this level again. Just so I can actually beat the Darknut. Okay. Round two, buddy. Yeah, I'm not even gonna bother for score in this case. Especially with these things around me. Come on. Yeah, I'm already at this phase. You gonna attack me? Yeah, you have to hit those things to actually do real damage. Come on, where's the white things? That's two. Or, no, yeah, I actually did real damage. And then I actually defeat the enemy. And you get a humongous bonus, jeez. Huh. Seriously? I never beat him? Huh. Kinda surprised. Well, whatever, I got a pretty good score, but unfortunately not enough to get a gold. Anyway, level final. Let's get this game over with. Not even gonna bother doing the... I don't think I'll be redoing the Fossil Star Lord battle, but it's the other highlight of the game, that's for sure. Also, rescue goats from goblins. Hooray! How am I gonna rescue them? Oh, by hitting the goblins off of the goats, yeah. Yep. Careful not to hit the goats themselves. Also, these animations are completely reminiscent of the two rangers of Majora's Mask. Yay! Unfortunately, I lost my multiplier. This is actually kind of easy. Damn it! Did I hit a goat? I don't think I did, but it's a bit hard to keep up because it gets intense at the end of the phases. The hell? Damn it. Lost the goat. Lost two goats at least. Oh well. Never liked those buggers anyway. Sacred Grove Defender. Skull Kid's creating havoc with his army of puppets. Gotta take him down. Yeah, they take several hits. Oh, wow, that troll. You still there? Thanks. But I'm not gonna get a good score out of this. Maybe I will, who knows? What about this thing? That's more points, that's for sure. Yeah, you can get tons of points in this game, jeez. Right above me? Jeez, what a troll. This level is a troll. Are we almost done? Guess we are now. Yep. Didn't get hit a single time, but I did not get a great score either. Kind of crazy that I almost got 50,000 in this stage. You could probably get a humongous score if you're really good, actually. Anyway, yeah. Star Lord battle. Another great highlight of this game, this mini game. I mean, it's not very surprising. Star-Lord was a highlight of the original Twilight Princess. In this game, he can breathe fire, I think. It's a little strange, but I mean, it works. You cannot move, by the way. Oh, you gotta hit his arms. Several times. Damn it. That. Now what am I gonna have to hit? No. Yep, 5 times I think. And then it regrows its arms. Somehow. Damn it. It's moving faster. There we go. Arm 2. Damn it. Try to hit me with your second arm. Cannot destroy it. Real quick. They've done some big damage. Yes. Come on. Okay. And then it goes all the way back over there. Okay, okay. I think I have to do this one more time to actually fully beat Star-Lord. I only have 30 seconds. Ugh! I've got to hit the other arm! 15 seconds left. I don't think I'm going to make it. Maybe I will. Who knows? Time to finish this! Fall! Yeah! The best. Always the best. You get, like, the bonus points, like, use your multiplier, right? Maybe that's how you get a crazy, insanely high score. Yeah. Okay. Well, whatever. I enjoyed myself a lot, that's for sure. Unfortunately, that's pretty much it for Link's crossbow training. Besides those two highlights, the game is just kinda, I mean, it kinda happens, you know? Back in the Wii era, Nintendo was quite fond about making gimmicky Wii-mote games, But most people were hoping for experiences that would be entertaining for more than just 1 hour. Or 10 minutes in some people's cases. Anyway, I don't think I'll be replaying this for high score. I don't know how multiplayer works. It's kind of strange that this game has it. But as far as Twilight Princess era content is concerned, I've covered all of it. Well, actually, there's that Picross game. Well, if I ever figure out how to record stuff off my 3DS, I'll cover Twilight Princess Picross or Picross, whatever it's called, too. But for now, that's it. That's it for Twilight Princess stuff. Hope you've all enjoyed this mini-series and hope you all have a very nice day. Bye-bye!